Network for आप देख रहे हैं दीपक विकर्णा। टुडे इन दिस क्लास वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट ड्रिप वेलोसिटी। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी हैव टू नो व्हाट डज इट मीन ड्रिप वेलोसिटी। ड्रिप वेलोसिटी होता क्या है? सपोज दिस इज योर कंडक्टर एंड इफ वी आर अप्लाइंग ए पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस अप्लाइड अक्रॉस इट देन व्हाट इज द सिनेरियो इट विल कम। So, इसमें क्या होता है, अगर मैं पोटेंशियल भी देता हूँ ये पॉजिटिव टर्मिनल ये नेगेटिव टर्मिनल ऑल द पॉजिटिव चार्जेस विल एक्युमुलेट ऑन दिस साइड एंड नेगेटिव चार्जेस विल एक्युमुलेट ऑन दिस साइड। ओके सेम अमाउंट ऑफ नेगेटिव चार्जेस विल एक्युमुलेट ऑन दिस साइड। सो क्या होगा, उसके बाद द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड विल जनरेट और इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड विल प्रोड्यूस इन साइड द कंडक्टर। But it, since electric field will be created inside the conductor, the electrons present inside this conductor will move. ये जो इलेक्ट्रॉन होता है वो क्या होता है, इट विल गेट ड्रिफ्टेड, इट विल गेट ड्रिफ्टेड और इट विल ड्रिफ्ट। ओके सो व्हेन द इलेक्ट्रॉन ऑफ दिस कंडक्टर विल ड्रिफ्ट when we are applying an electric field, okay, and how this electric field will come due to this source. Here we are considering any battery or any cell, okay, किसी cell से potential लिए हैं, potential लेने के बाद electric field आया, electric field आने के बाद क्या हुआ, this electron will move in opposite direction of this electric field. But it, why? Because electron is negatively charged. Since it is negatively charged, it will move opposite to the electric field. So we can define the drift velocity as the average velocity of the free electron. Okay, the average velocity of the free electron gained by the external electric field in opposite direction of electric field. Okay, so drift velocity is the velocity gained by the free electron in opposite direction of electric field when an external electric field is applied on this conductor. Got it? जब हम इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड दे रहे हैं, इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड देने के बाद इलेक्ट्रॉन मूव कर रहा है, इलेक्ट्रॉन ड्रिफ्ट कर रहा है। सो इलेक्ट्रॉन किस तरह ड्रिफ्ट करेगा, इन द ऑपोजिट डिरेक्शन ऑफ दिस इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड। इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड जिस तरफ होगा इलेक्ट्रॉन ऑपोजिटली मूव करेगा, उसको क्या बोलते हैं, ड्रिफ्टिंग। सो व्हेनेवर यू विल सी द वर्ड ड्रिफ्ट दैट मींस ऑब्वियसली वन इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड विल बी देयर। इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड देने के बाद चार्जेस जो मूव करता है उसको बोलते हैं ड्रिफ्ट। इन केस ऑफ सेमीकंडक्टर वी यू विल सी अनदर वर्ड डिफ्यूजन। डिफ्यूजन ड्रिफ्ट करंट डिफ्यूजन करंट एट दैट टाइम इन दिस केस डिफ्यूजन मींस व्हेन एवर द कंसंट्रेशन इज हायर then from higher concentration to lower concentration the charge will move and at that time diffusion will come into picture, whereas whenever there is an electric field and the charges will move at that time the movement is called drifting. What is so electric field jab hoga tab drifting bola jayega, whereas concentration jo hoga tab diffusion bola jayega. Ye semiconductor mein hoga. So time being we will remove this part. So whenever electric field is applied on this conductor then the electron, because in the conductor electrons are plentifully available, so we are considering only electrons. Electrons are moving opposite to this electric field and the velocity gained by this electron is called your drift velocity. ड्रिफ्ट किस लिए हो रहा है, ड्रिफ्ट हो रहा है इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड की वजह से, और वेलोसिटी किसका है, इलेक्ट्रॉन का। सो दिस इज योर ड्रिफ्ट वेलोसिटी। गॉट इट? सो दिस इज द डेफिनेशन ऑफ ड्रिफ्ट वेलोसिटी। नाउ वी विल कैलकुलेट द एक्सप्रेशन फॉर द ड्रिफ्ट वेलोसिटी। व्हाट इज द फॉर्मूला फॉर द ड्रिफ्ट वेलोसिटी? सो फॉर दैट यू हैव टू कंसीडर वन कंडक्टर एंड यू हैव टू अप्लाई ए पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस across that conductor. Length of this conductor is L. This is the potential we are applying. Okay, so obviously positive charges will remain here, negative charges will remain on other side. So there will be electric field E along this direction, and since electric field is along this direction, so electron will move. This one is the electron. Electron will move in opposite direction, which is your nothing but drift velocity. Okay, so as electron is moving in opposite direction, so the velocity gained by the electron is your vd, and we have to find the expression for that drift velocity. This is important. Drift velocity for electron, the derivation you may get in your question. Okay, so first of all, before applying this potential or before applying the electric field, before applying the electric field, what is the velocity of all the electrons present inside the conductor? A conductor may suppose there are n number of electrons are present in this conductor. Okay, सिंस इलेक्ट्रॉन्स आर प्रेजेंट, और इलेक्ट्रॉन के बीच में क्या होता रहेगा, वेलोसिटी इनिशियल वेलोसिटी भी कुछ होगा. व्हाई? बिकॉज़ ड्यू टू थर्मल एक्सपांशन देयर विल बी सम इनिशियल वेलोसिटी, इनिशियल मूवमेंट ऑफ ऑल द इलेक्ट्रॉन्स आर प्रेजेंट इनसाइड द कंडक्टर बिफोर अप्लाइंग. ये हो गया हमारा बिफोर अप्लाइंग इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड. So before applying electric field, क्या हो रहा है इसमें इनिशियल वेलोसिटी सभी का होता है. ये इलेक्ट्रॉन सपोज इस तरफ जा रहा है, ये इलेक्ट्रॉन इस तरफ जाएगा, ये इलेक्ट्रॉन सपोज इस तरफ, ये इलेक्ट्रॉन इस तरफ, लाइक ओके. सिंस ऑल दी वेलोसिटीज, वेलोसिटीज आर वेक्टर क्वांटिटी, एंड ऑल दी वेलोसिटीज आर इन रैंडम डिरेक्शन, रैंडम ओरिएंटेड. ये सब क्या है, रैंडम डिरेक्शन में है, रैंडम ओरिएंटेड में है. एक इस तरफ हो रहा है, एक इस तरफ, लाइक दिस. सो क्या होगा, एज द वेलोसिटी इज वेक्टर क्वांटिटी, सो द नेट और रिजल्टेंट वेलोसिटी विल बिकम जीरो. सो सपोज यू वन, यू टू एंड सिमिलरली यू एन आर दी इनिशियल वेलोसिटीज of n electrons before applying electric field. May our u1, u2 and un are the initial velocities of the n number of electrons. Okay, then the average velocity or net velocity can be written as what? So net velocity can be written as summation of ui, this is the average velocity or net velocity. So this one will become u1 plus u2 plus divided by n. Why? N number of electrons are present, so we are doing the average. So as this is the vector quantity, net or resultant velocity will become what? What? Due to random direction or due to random variation. सब इधर उधर होता है, क्यों इधर उधर होने के बाद हम क्या करेंगे, उसका रिजल्टेंट निकालेंगे. ये हो गया दो दो वेलोसिटी, मतलब रिजल्टेंट किस तरह होगा, इस तरफ होगा. ओके, और ऐसा अगर इस तरफ वेलोसिटी हो गया तो उसका रिजल्टेंट जो होगा जीरो हो जाएगा. सिमिलरली सभी अगर मिल जाएंगे तो क्या होगा, जो हमारा वेलोसिटी है इनिशियल वेलोसिटी विल बिकम जीरो. But after applying electric field, the scenario will change. Okay, the environment will change inside the conductor. क्या हो रहा है, after applying electric field, सभी electron को क्या हो गया, उसको हम electric field देने के बाद वो electron सब क्या कर रहे हैं, movement कर रहे हैं. किस दिशा में, एक ही दिशा में. Okay, in one direction all the electrons are moving. Got it? And that is opposite to the electric field. Got it? Electric field देने के बाद सभी इलेक्ट्रॉन क्या कर रहे हैं, ऑपोजिट साइड पे मूवमेंट कर रहे हैं. व्हाट इट सो एज इट इज मूविंग इन ऑपोजिट डिरेक्शन एंड द डिरेक्शंस ऑफ ऑल द चार्जेस आर इन वन डिरेक्शन सो नेट वेलोसिटी विल बी देयर एंड वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट दैट वेलोसिटी. व्हाट इट अगेन फ्रॉम द काइनेटिक इक्वेशन all of you know that v is equal to what u plus a into t, yes or no? So this is the equation, first equation of kinematics. So v is equal to u plus a into t. Here we will consider the initial velocity of each electron. Suppose we are considering for first electron, in first electron the final velocity is equal to initial velocity plus acceleration into time tau. In place of t, we are representing as this one tau and this is 1. 1 is corresponding for first electron. So v1 equal to u1 plus a tau 1. And this is all our, these all are vector quantity, velocity and acceleration. Okay. Similarly, for second electron, V2 is equal to U2 plus A into tau T2. Similarly, for n number of electron, Vn is equal to Un plus A into tau n. All these are vector quantity, so we are representing in vector. But it and we have to calculate the acceleration. So for acceleration, what you know as acceleration is equal to what? Force upon mass. Suppose we are considering for one electron. Ek electron ke liye main calculate kar raha hu acceleration kitna hoga. Acceleration is equal to force upon mass and force is equal to what? Force is equal to q into e, but we are considering here electron. So this one is electron. Q into E divided by M. Got it? Q into E divided by M. Force is this one, F equal to E divided by M. And acceleration and electric field. The direction of acceleration is opposite to the electric field. क्यों? देखो वेलोसिटी इस तरफ हो रहा है, देखो वेलोसिटी इस तरफ हो रहा है, इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इस तरफ, सॉरी दिस वन इज इलेक्ट्रॉन, सो इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इस तरफ है, वेलोसिटी इस तरफ हो रहा है. बट इट सो एज वी आर फाइंडिंग द एक्सेलरेशन हियर, सो एक्सेलरेशन इज ऑपोजिट टू द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड. एक्सेलरेशन धीरे धीरे क्या होता जाएगा, धीरे धीरे घटता जाएगा. So acceleration A is equal to E upon M. Whenever we are representing in our sign, we have to represent it in vector form. क्यों? Vector form देने के बाद हमें पता चल रहा है कि acceleration is opposite to the electric field. Got it? So here we will represent this one. We will just put this expression in place of here. So average velocity gained by this electron. So average velocity is equal to what? V1 plus V2 plus ... up to how much? Vn divided by what it? So this is the average velocity gained by this electron, and we call that one as drift velocity. So this is the Vd equal to V1 plus V2 plus up to Vn divided by n. We have to replace all this. So V1 is equal to what? U1 plus A tau 1 plus this one is U2 plus A tau 2 plus ... up to Un plus A tau m divided by n. So this equal to, that implies Vd is equal to, we will write all the terms u terms in one position and all other terms in other position. So u1 plus u2 plus dot 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 up to un divided by n plus a tau1 plus a tau2 plus dot 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 up to this one is a tau n divided by n. So this one will become what? H, this is the average initial velocity, and average initial velocity is how much? 0 plus this one is how much? So this one A constant for every electron, and this is tau 1 plus tau 2 plus tau n divided by n. So this one will become acceleration. In place of acceleration, we will replace this one minus EE by n, minus E by n, and this one tau 1 plus tau 2 plus tau n divided by n, we can represent as tau. Here tau is called as relaxation time. Here tau, so this is our last expression. So here tau is called, here tau is called average relaxation time. Average relaxation time. And tau 1, tau 2, tau n can be defined as what? Only relaxation time. That means tau 1 is defined as the relaxation time for first electron. Tau 2 is the relaxation time for second electron. Similarly, tau n is the relaxation time for nth electron. Got it? So what does it mean, relaxation time? देखो क्या हो रहा है इसमें, जब ये मतलब फर्स्ट इलेक्ट्रॉन है, नाउ लाइक दिस, अगर दिस वन इज फर्स्ट इलेक्ट्रॉन, दिस वन इज सेकेंड इलेक्ट्रॉन, दिस वन इज थर्ड इलेक्ट्रॉन. Got it? So ये फर्स्ट इलेक्ट्रॉन अगर मूवमेंट करके इसके ऊपर अगर कोलाइड होगा, दैट मींस एट दैट टाइम दिस फर्स्ट इलेक्ट्रॉन विल रिलैक्स. सिमिलरली सेकेंड विल कोलाइड टू फर्स्ट वन एंड दिस वन इज सेकेंड. सो क्या होगा, ए है इलेक्ट्रॉन, इलेक्ट्रॉन आगे जाके सक्सेसिव जाके उसमें कोलाइड हो रहा है. फर्स्ट इलेक्ट्रॉन विल कोलाइड टू नेवर, देन वन सेकेंड वन विल कोलाइड टू फर्स्ट वन, थर्ड वन विल कोलाइड टू सेकेंड वन, लाइक दैट. सो व्हेन एवर वन इलेक्ट्रॉन इज कोलाइड टू अनदर, तो फर्स्ट वन व्हाट विल हैपन, फर्स्ट वन विल बिकम रिलैक्स. अगर मान लो एक लाइन पे खड़े हैं, अगर कोई हमें धकेल रहा है तो क्या होगा, मैं जाके गिरूंगा और किसी के ऊपर. सो क्या होगा, मैं जाके गिरूंगा और उधर मैं रुक जाऊंगा, दैट मीन्स आई एम रिलैक्स नाउ. व्हाट इट, सो टाइम एलास्ट बिटवीन द टू इलेक्ट्रॉन इज कॉल्ड रिलैक्सेशन टाइम. ओके, और सक्सेसिव कोलिजन टाइम. सो क्या होता है, क्योंकि एक इलेक्ट्रॉन जाके दूसरे में गिरता है, सो दैट इज द टाइम एलास्ट बाय बिटवीन दैट इलेक्ट्रॉन एंड दैट इज कॉल्ड योर रिलैक्सेशन टाइम. सो रिलैक्सेशन टाइम किसको बोलते हैं, क्योंकि एक इलेक्ट्रॉन जाके दूसरा पे गिरता है, उसके ऊपर कोलाइड होता है, उसके बाद वो रिलैक्स हो जाता है, जितना टाइम लेता है उसको बोलते हैं रिलैक्सेशन टाइम. सो टाउ वन इज द रिलैक्सेशन टाइम फॉर फर्स्ट इलेक्ट्रॉन, सिमिलरली टाउ टू इज द रिलैक्सेशन टाइम फॉर सेकेंड इलेक्ट्रॉन एंड सो ऑन. सो टाउ इज कॉल्ड एज एवरेज रिलैक्सेशन टाइम. सो सभी को जितना भी इलेक्ट्रॉन है, पास पास में होता है, बहुत पास में होता है, सो रिलैक्सेशन टाइम एवरेज अगर कर लेंगे, सो उसको डिनोट करेंगे टाउ. Got it? So here tau is the average one. And in case of conductor, the value of tau nearly equal to 10 to the power minus 14 second. इतने आसपास होता है. Got it? So सोच लो कितना कम होता है, 10 to the power minus 14 second. Got it? So this is the tau relaxation time. So this one is the drift velocity for electron. Always you have to consider the drift velocity for electron only. Whenever the
electric field is applied on the conductor. Got it? So electric field. So we can write this one as. So we can write BD is equal to minus E tau. I am writing here E tau upon N into E. And electric field is also vector quantity. Velocity is also vector quantity. So drift velocity is opposite to the electric field. Got it? Drift velocity kis taraf ho raha hai? Opposite. So here this negative sign indicates that the drift velocity of electron is opposite to that of electric field. Got it? So negative sign ka ye importance kya hota hai, matlab kya hota hai? This is, this will give the direction of the drift velocity due to electric field. Okay? And it is opposite of that. Alright, so this is the expression for the drift velocity of any conductor, of any electron inside the conductor. Got it? Lekin drift velocity hota kab hai? Jab electric field dete hai. Again, electric field is what? Again, electric field is equal to V upon L, where L is the length and V is the potential difference applied across these two ends. Okay, so E equal to V by L. So we can write VD is equal to E tau upon N V by L. Okay, so this is also one of the formula when potential applied across the conductor of length L is given. Got it? So drift velocity. Here I am not writing the sign here because we are considering only magnitude, because potential is also a scalar quantity, so we are not considering the direction of the drift velocity. But in this case we will consider the direction. Got it? Because electric field will be given and electric field is a vector quantity, so drift velocity is opposite to the electric field. Next is your Ohm's law in vector form. For this, we have to write, we have to consider a conductor of length L. We are applying a potential difference V across its two ends, such that the electrons is getting drifted. Okay, so potential देने के बाद electric field generate हो रहा है, और electric field generate होने के बाद already इसमें electron is getting drifted. Here this is your electric field, and this is your positive charges, and this one is your negative charges. So electron is moving in opposite direction with velocity V, drift velocity V. And we know the drift velocity is what? VD is equal to minus E tau upon N into E. This is the drift velocity of electron. So here we have to derive the Ohm's law in vector form. Let n be the number of electrons per unit volume. Let n be the number of electrons per unit volume. Per unit volume. Okay, then the charge of the conductor Q is equal to what? Q is equal to, already we know, N from quantization. Okay, Q equal to N, N is the number of electron, and this is the, E is the electronic charge. So Q equal to N E, but here n is the number of electrons per unit volume. So we will consider here volume. So here number of electron into volume into electronic charge. Okay, for volume we will consider the area of cross section of this conductor, let it be A, and L is the length. So volume can be written as what? So this is M into volume is area into length. So A into L into E. So this is M E A into L. So this is the total charge of the conductor of the volume A into L. A into L जिसमें volume है A into L, उसमें कितना charge होगा? N into A into L into E. So this is Q. So total charge is this one. Okay. So the current can be defined as what? Charge per time. Got it? Again, we can write this one as N E A L divided upon T. That implies when we will consider only L upon T. Okay, when we will consider L upon T, what will give it? ये क्या रहेगा हमको? Length divided by time. क्या रहता है हमें? Speed or velocity. So here it is the velocity of the electron. Why? Because L is the length of this conductor. If charge कहां से कहां गया है? This end से ये end. Got it? So L is the length of this conductor in which or through which the charges is moving from one end to other end. Got it? So here L upon T is nothing but our beam velocity Vd. So we will write this one as, that implies I is equal to N E A into V. We have to write as V D is equal to L upon length by time. Got it? So this is also one of the important expression between current and deep velocity. Whenever we have to ask to write the relation between current and deep velocity, you have to write I equal to N E A V D, and it is also one of the important formula to solve the numerical. So I equal to N E A V D. Again, I upon A is equal to this one N E into V D. Okay? So here I divided by A is equal to N E V D. Again, I by A is what? I upon A is nothing but your current density J into N E V D. Also we have calculated here. So V D is equal to E tau by M into E. By considering only its magnitude, we can write E tau upon M into E. So this one will become N E square tau upon M into E. Okay, so J is equal to what? J is equal to N E square tau upon M, and all these are constant. Okay, so we can write this one as J is equal to a constant here sigma into E. And electric field is also vector quantity, and current density is also a vector quantity. This is your final expression for Ohm's law in vector form. J is equal to sigma E, where this sigma is called is your what? Conductivity. Conductivity of this conductor. conductivity of any material, you can say, but here we are considering the conductor, so we will write conductivity of conductor. Got it? So J equal to sigma is applicable in any type of conductor, कुछ भी हो, चाहे distributed हो, चाहे undistributed हो, उसमें J equal to sigma A is the important. It is your Ohm's law in vector form. So you have to write. This is the expression for Ohm's law in vector form. Ohm's law in vector form. Got it? So J equal to sigma I, where sigma is one constant and sigma is called conductivity of the conductor, and its expression can be written as N E square tau by N. Tau is depending on the material, okay? But for any type of material, tau is constant. It different to iron, different to silver, different to gold, different to aluminium. But tau is same for iron. Got it? It is always constant. So N is constant, E is also one constant, tau constant, and M is also constant. M is the mass of the electron. So all are constant things. So conductivity is also a constant thing. It depends on the material. Okay. So J equal to sigma is our Ohm's law in vector form. Next we will see the scalar form. Next is your Ohm's law in scalar form. We can derive it from Ohm's law in vector form. As J is equal to sigma into E. Okay, we will consider only magnitude because we are deriving the Ohm's law in scalar form. And J is equal to what? I upon A. E is equal to what? E is equal to V upon L. And again, this sigma is equal to 1 upon rho, where sigma is called conductivity, sigma is your conductivity of the conductor, of the conductor, and rho is the reverse of that one, inverse of that one, so it is your resistivity of the conductor. Okay, so sigma is equal to 1 upon rho. So by substituting all this relation, we can write as I upon A is equal to, in place of sigma we will write 1 upon rho is equal to V upon A. That implies I into rho L A, rho L divided by A is equal to V. So that implies we can write V is equal to I into one constant. Why? Because rho is one constant, L is the length of the conductor, again constant, A is the area of the cross section, again constant. So we will write in one constant, that is your R into I. This is our Ohm's law in scalar form, and where R is the resistance of the conductor. Resistance of the conductor. Okay, जो भी conductor लेंगे उसका resistance. So V equal to R into I. This is our Ohm's law in scalar form. Why? Because this is the current is a scalar quantity. Again, potential is also a scalar quantity. So this is your Ohm's law in scalar form. So we can write the statement of this one, Ohm's law का statement इस तरह दिखेंगे. The current flowing through a conductor is directly proportional to the potential applied across that conductor at constant temperature, pressure, etc. What is it? That means the current is directly proportional to the potential applied across that conductor. हमेशा current मतलब क्या होता है, कंडक्टर के थ्रू ही जाता है. What is it? Suppose this is your conductor, then current will flow through this conductor. And if we are writing the potential, then potential is always across. ये जो टर्मिनल है, ये दो तो टर्मिनल है, इस दो तो टर्मिनल के बीच में पोटेंशियल कितना है. सो पोटेंशियल इज ऑलवेज कैलकुलेटेड अक्रॉस एनी टर्मिनल, अक्रॉस एनी डिवाइस. व्हाट इट वेयरस करंट इज फाइंडिंग आउट थ्रू द कंडक्टर, थ्रू द सेल. ओके, सो करंट फ्लोइंग थ्रू द कंडक्टर इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू द पोटेंशियल अप्लाइड अक्रॉस दैट कंडक्टर एट कॉन्स्टेंट टेम्परेचर, प्रेशर एंड एटमोस्फेरिक कंडीशन एक्सेट्रा. ओके, दिस वन इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. इफ टेम्परेचर विल चेंजेस देन दिस रिलेशन विल नॉट वेरी, वेयर एज जे इक्वल टू सिग्मा ई फॉर्म फॉर ई वेक्टर फॉर्म इज ऑलवेज वेरी while changing the temperature, pressure, etc. So this one is very useful one. This is also one useful whenever we consider the elements or components. कुछ भी elements, resistance हो गया, capacitance हो गया, inductor हो गया, तो ये use होता है Ohm's law in scalar form. But Ohm's law in vector form we can use in any form also. Okay, distributive case में भी वो use हो सकता है. So this is the statement of Ohm's law. Okay, thank you everyone.